We can confirm that WWE released Tony Chimel, one of around a dozen individuals that have been let go recently. He had been with the company in one form or another since 1983. I believe he became a full-time ring announcer around 1991. I was 7 years old when Tony Chimel began doing work for WWE. Now he has been released in the middle of a pandemic. As noted, about a dozen individuals released over the last couple of days. And, I mean, the story here is obvious, besides the fact that they're releasing people in the middle of a pandemic. Story is that they ain't going back to live events anytime soon. Everybody that they released in one form or another worked on the live event side, whether it was within merchandising or ring announcing or whatever. So, obviously, they're here in the Thunderdome. They got to get out of the Thunderdome by early December, move into a new Thunderdome. But it does appear, this is not confirmed, WWE has not confirmed this. This is merely my speculation. It has been my speculation, by the way, for months now, that even when this pandemic is over, WWE's road schedule is going to be drastically reduced. I'm not saying there will never be house shows again, but I would not be surprised if it was largely just Raw, SmackDown, NXT, and pay-per-views, an occasional house show at a Madison Square Garden or something like that. But I'm pretty confident that the days of 4 days a week on the road if you're on Raw, 4 days a week on the road if you're SmackDown, dude, I think that's over. I think that's history. Things can change. It might be history now, and they'll bring it back down the road if the company catches fire, who even knows. But the fact that they gutted the live event department right here tells me that right now the feeling is, that's it. We're a television company now. So, sucks for Tony Chimel. Hopefully they paid him a lot of money over the years, and he'll be all right. But there you go.
Yeah, it always sucks to see somebody lose their job, especially somebody that's been around for that long. And WWE has a lot of people under their employ, and they have a lot of people that aren't really doing a whole lot right now under the circumstances and may not do a whole lot because of the circumstances of the future. But with that said, I've never been in that type of corporate management position to have that much money, you know, to lay somebody off during a pandemic at this time. I don't know. I guess you go, well, is there a good time? But when you release record profits like this and everything that's going on, you know, I'm not in their pockets, but you just kind of like, it's one of those things where it's like, man, just for that guy's sake and just because, you know, you put yourself in that position, at least I do, because I'm closer to somebody like that than I am in the realm of the Vince McMahon boardroom world with all those zeros in my bank account. So, like, anytime something like this happens, you just, man, say you wish you could have let him hold on for as long as you possibly could. And, you know, you talk about what it could be like once they do actually come back, and they have a lot of guys there if they, you know, depending, and who knows what house shows will look like when they come back as well too. It's going to be a really, this era we're going to look back on in a lot of different ways, and there's going to be a lot of think tanks and a lot of that gets written about all of this time in every aspect of life. But professional wrestling for sure is going to be one of those things, because we may have seen the biggest shift in all of pro wrestling, you know, and its structure ever, you know, honestly ever, as far as always being the touring carny thing. And, you know, yeah, it's been a TV product for a long time, and the TV product obviously, you know, became the big monster, but house shows were always important for merch and all that sort of stuff. And now we're seeing merch sold directly to you on Twitch and directly to you in other ways. So yeah, I mean, house shows, when they, if and when they come back, it's going to be fascinating to see actually what this whole thing looks like.
If you love these video clips, head down there to the bottom right-hand side of the screen and click join. For just $7.99 per month, you get full access to all of the episodes, over 300 at current count, full-length episodes of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, and Figure Four Daily with both Lance Storm and Filthy Tom Lawler. You can also hit that subscribe button, and you'll always be alerted as to when new shows are available.